Hey everybody, welcome. Welcome back if you've been here before to Nothing's Wrong podcast. I'm Isabel.
And I'm Catherine.
And happy Easter!
Happy Easter!
You see, we're in the mood. We got our bunnies. Mm-hmm. We are little bunnies.
Little bunnies here. So make sure you guys are liking
right. And
sharing the post as we go live right now so everybody can get on in here. And we also have YouTube online.
Hi, YouTube! So
that is going to be really fun because we've been like not thinking, and for some reason we just thought that you couldn't go live on YouTube if you didn't have 1,000 subs, which unfortunately we don't have.
Yeah.
But that was only for mobile, and we didn't know that we can do it on the laptop.
Ugh,
so
we're so excited.
Not been going live on YouTube and only Facebook, so yeah, we're not that smart, but we got there.
You're not that smart. I am very smart, and I didn't know this was happening, but I'm so glad that we are able to also be live on YouTube. So hi, YouTube family. Make sure you guys are commenting down below today,
yeah. And
you're also liking this. And also for our Facebook family, do the same, and you guys go ahead and share this so more people know that you're in here, because we got a lot to say tonight.
The bunnies are speaking.
The honey bunnies are speaking.
Right,
okay, honey bunnies. Let us know if you
You remember honey bunnies?
Oh, yeah. I was killing those things a long time ago. I would always order them. Like, every time I would go shopping as a kid with my spending money, honey buns was part of it.
Yeah.
Also, a large slice of, a slice of cheese pizza.
Yeah.
Chachos.
Yeah. Mine's was like, I would go to the corner store and I would get like all of those candies that are like 5 cents and like,
girl,
10 cents. I would like have a big bag of candy at like $5.
Can I tell you which candy was inside of yours?
I already know, girl. Chico sticks.
I was just about to say, I wanted to tell it.
I was addicted to Chico sticks.
So everybody could be like, wow, you know your sister well.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah.
Girl, of course you do.
Right. It was definitely
I love Chico sticks, Babaloo gum.
And also the sweetest fish.
Sour patches. And anything else that I could afford. And gum.
Yeah.
And that was that. And I would just kill it all day.
That was so funny. So crazy, because it's like back in the day, life was just so good. You're like, all my spending money is for my little snacks, and then also I'm gonna go ahead and buy, you know, real food. It was like we were going to the corner store every second. How many times are you gonna go buy your Chico stick? You know what I mean?
Right.
Every single day you have that order. But hey, it's Easter. I hope you all had a nice little Easter. We had an Easter egg hunt today, and
yeah.
Oh, I'm excited. Thank you for the love. Make sure you comment.
Make sure you guys are liking. I know we just came in here and y'all are still filing in. And as you can see on the title, you can see that life, death, rebirth.
Why is it all that?
Phoenix rising.
Oh,
and I think that was appropriate rather than, because I don't know, does everybody celebrate Easter?
Let me tell you.
Is it like a everybody holiday type of thing?
No, it's a Christian holiday.
It's a Christian holiday or a Catholic holiday.
Yeah.
So you can't really, you can understand what it means and what it represents and so many other things. And the phoenix represents that and, you know, being burnt down and then rising out of the ashes.
Yeah. Yes.
And that's the same analogy as in the, Christian faith where Jesus died
and Jesus was reborn.
But that all in all is a great analogy for, you know, to take it all in. And I think that's important. Like when people read either the Bible or anything, watch anything. I think anything and everything in the world is always trying to tell you about yourself. And if you explore the story and you put it to yourself, like, all of your problems can be fixed. Right. Free therapy right there.
Free therapy. Hit the like button for that free therapy. I love that it was the love button. So hit the love button. I like that there's different options. So hit the love button because that was real truth analogy. And then I was also asking, like, because I didn't know how to get started with this conversation. It's like, where do we go from here? You know? And then she's like, you know, this is my sister's personality. Think. What do you think it's about? And I was like, well, I don't know. Let me use the analogy of, you know, someone going to jail and coming back and being reborn and becoming a better person. But then sometimes that's not even the case with some people. They just go back to that same birth that they had from the beginning. They don't actually transition into the reborn.
But I think now, the reason why I think the conversation is important, like how it always comes up this time of the year, it's really now, since so many people have been exposed, like all over the internet, all over everywhere. Is that my phone?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'm just.
She's so always distracted.
I am distracted.
Yeah.
Because I don't know why you're on my phone.
Because I'm doing something. Like, go ahead.
Yeah. So, I just think that I lost my train of thought. Amazing.
You're going to have to take it over.
I was doing something.
I know what you're doing.
I did it already.
No.
I know what you're doing.
Yeah. No, you were on a track. Go, because it was important. Go ahead.
Cheers.
Ladies and gentlemen, cheers to our go ahead. Let them know.
It's pineapple our sangria, guys.
Yes, pineapple sangria. Thank you so much, Ipiderm, for this lovely, lovely
sangria. Drink. This is so delicious. Mm-hmm. I was obsessed.
You need to sell this. This is
anyways,
amazing.
Let's get into it. Mm-hmm. Hope you guys can hear us and all that stuff. Let us
Your
know.
Phone is locking up on us.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah. Let us know that you're in here and happy holidays to you all. Mm-hmm. You know, when we say holiday, every holiday to us is happy Thanksgiving. Oh, yeah. It's Thanksgiving? Like, no, it's not Thanksgiving.
I know.
It's actually Easter.
It's always Thanksgiving.
Right.
I always.
Is it because food is involved?
There's food in every holiday. Uh-huh. And I think, like, in all of those holidays, they all represent giving thanks. So it's like a blanket statement of saying, you know. Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Happy Thanksgiving, guys.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Hi. Let me see. Yeah. Ipiderm says, hi, dear. Happy Easter.
Oh, yeah. I was going to say she's wrong. It's
Thanksgiving. Yeah, no, me too.
Happy Thanksgiving.
I was definitely going to be like, happy Easter. We're on one today. Sorry,
on one from Sangria.
Sangria.
You was on a mission.
Thank you.
You was on a mission and we literally switched the subject on you. And it was so juicy and you were just over here minding my business.
Yeah. Well, that's what happens sometimes. Anyways, well, have you heard about DMX?
Oh my gosh, yes. You actually asked me that question recently. Yeah. And then I was like, oh, he's in the hospital.
Yeah.
And then I was like, oh, he's back at it again doing the same thing. Is he in the transition of the you know, rebirth that might be happening?
Hopefully. If he makes it out of here.
Right.
And I mean, that literally, right? See,
right.
What I was saying earlier that the life will show you things in real life. Mm-hmm. Like things will always talk to you and present itself to you and let you know like what you need to know right now in the moments if people are into it. Seeing that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that's crazy that
he's going through that.
Yeah. I mean, I love his music and to see him.
I just heard that he had an interview, so it's like kind of interesting to me that he is.
I remember he
this.
Was on like Wendy Williams.
Oh yeah. Like that. Yeah. He showed her that he wasn't too crazy. Like, oh, okay. Like, you know, there's something about you. Like, you know, but, and
I think like with drugs, it's like so hard for people, and it really is hard. Like drugs is a hard thing to get over because we live in a drug infested world.
Right.
Like everything's a drug. Even your food is a drug. Mm-hmm. McDonald's is a drug. Everything's a drug.
Yeah.
So if like people have like people in America, since we have the highest number of obese people, I would think that it's mostly because food is a drug. They pump hormones in it. They make you like these things are so addictive and yeah. they like can take over your life. And if you're not strong enough or if you're so deep that it becomes like a life journey, a mm-hmm. battle mm-hmm. that you have to continue to face. So that's really, really hard.
Yeah, it's sad because like we were also having a conversation about how why do they allow like alcohol to like, you know, be involved, because I mean not involved.
That legalize
alcohol when there's a lot of DUI, people get DUIs, people do hit and runs.
You're right.
You know, different kind of things happen. And if they had took alcohol as being legal, we wouldn't have much crime, but well, we'll have much crime, obviously, but
a lot of things happen on alcohol, mm-hmm. but I think to uncover why would go way too deep down the rabbit hole, and we don't know how woke y'all are.
I'm woke.
No, you're not.
Right, you don't want to get woke here. You know, people don't like that here.
Yeah.
They like us to talk about, did you guys hear about Sweetie? That's what they want to know. Sweetie and Quavo, right? I know that. Mm. That elevator stuff that happened, right?
That's even symbolism right there. Mm-hmm. That happened in the elevator. Even what's Jay-Z and Beyonce elevator, Solange. Mm-hmm. Like things happen in the elevator. Didn't that guy who was a football player beat up his wife in the elevator
too? Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
They be fighting in the elevator.
Mm-hmm.
So watch out, people. Watch out. Anyways,
life. Death and rebirth. Are you guys in that stage? I think that happened to me. I feel like I've also experienced that life, that death, and the rebirth. Mm-hmm. I'm at the rebirth right now.
Mm-hmm.
My death definitely happened a little bit when I was in New York and I went out with some people who I should never hung out with.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a drunk driver driving and he literally was smashing everybody. Like at first he was like swerving and we're like, are you good? Like, because everybody who's here got a license. Like, we could drive. Like, you don't got to take the wheel if you ain't good.
Right.
He's like, nah, I'm good. And then it's just like later on, he's like swerving, hitting everybody's thing. We're like, no, stop the car. He keeps going super fast. And
my car
tilts over. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, I'm dead. I'm dead. Like my family, I don't know, I'm finished. And all I thought about was them. And the car tilts back to its normal stage. And I was like, how did the car not flip over? Like that thing literally lifted up and went right back down. And that seems like a Jesus move over here. Cause I'm like, that's crazy. I should have been dead, hurt.
Right.
We left there with no bruises, nothing. And that kind of showed me death right there. And
what happened after that? Because even he was going through something, right?
Yeah, his father actually passed away that same day, but didn't really tell anybody like what was going on. And that person should never have been out in the world, and they should have just stayed home. But luckily enough. And the crazy thing is that all the cars in the back of us, this is on the highway in New York, and all the cars behind us literally stopped. They all stopped. You know when the police like stops the car to cause traffic here in LA, right? The same thing. They literally just stopped. They let us like die, basically.
Yeah.
And everybody stay safe. They played it cool. Like
good.
Nobody tried to pass us. No, they let us go. And that's like the same craziness that people do here in LA. They be driving so crazy.
It's
like,
so crazy.
Switching
on the
lanes and acting a fool.
I think I always see people like that and I'm mm-hmm. like, they must be young. Cause when yeah. I was young, I was whipping. Mm-hmm. I was like, I'm getting through everything and I'm getting through traffic fast.
Yeah.
And now that I'm older, I'm just like, I don't got the time.
I'm slow lady. You can cut me.
I'm gonna cut you.
I'm gonna cut you for sure.
But yeah. I cut long lines. I think I told mm-hmm. you guys that before.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Like what you said. So
my mom thought.
How did
thing.
You? What was the rebirth? Did you change after that? Did you stop?
doing. I'm like the jail people. I still was going.
You have to learn the lesson eventually.
Eventually, of course. It got even worse. I don't want to talk about what the next one happened that had to make me rebirth. Dive, but definitely just recently
so for
came
me
to a conclusion with myself.
For you, go ahead, let us know.
For me?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Oh, I
was just, you knew it was for you. He was like, for me. Go ahead, sweetie. It's your turn.
Well, for me, that drink tastes so good.
Amazing. Everybody go make you some.
It tastes like pineapple upside down cake.
Sangria.
This pineapple sangria, and it tastes amazing.
Go ahead. Tell it for me. You know it's your turn to shine.
No, but like my dip happened in Mexico for my birthday this year. I literally went through like the most craziest experience. Something that I won't share here because y'all like, ain't the mind that pays me.
Sure. Right. Sure.
Y'all ain't even talking.
Right. If you were talking, I would have been spilling some beans.
I might spill my beans and let you know what happened in Mexico, but since y'all ain't talking.
Oh, yeah. That you was definitely a rebirth. Go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah. You looked at me like that. And, you know, when I went exactly. And it was the most craziest thing because in normal circumstances, I don't think I would have been able to make it. But because it was specifically happened in Mexico, you know, I was able to just deal with it. And because I had no choice. Yeah. And
I'm all spilling your beans.
And basically, from that experience, it takes one experience. I think that just catapulted me into, like, you know, living my true self, authentic self. Because I feel like the life that I was living before wasn't that I wasn't being real or authentic. It was more so that I wasn't really going fully for what I want or even really knew what I want. Like, there were things that I thought I wanted and then realized I don't really want this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My lashes. But yeah. But aren't you excited that that happened though? Because you literally, I was proud of you because you really embraced the situation and you're like, yeah, I have no choice but to deal with
it
because
it's
my life and I'm going to have to move on and it's not a big deal. Like, you know?
But I went through so many other things that was so much more crazier, but that it'd be the littlest things
that make
that will
difference.
Be so crazy and it's like, okay, wow, this is life. And then from that experience it made me realize, like, you don't know anybody here. And that's what I think people need to, like, realize the most is, like, at the end of the day, nobody knows you. Nobody knows who you are. So whoever it is that you want to be, you can be.
Right.
Because nobody knows you.
Nobody.
Nobody can say, can put you in a box, can say, hey, I know you. You're supposed to be like this. So if you know that, you can do, you're limitless. You can do anything. And I think I just needed to go through something that was the realness for me. And yeah.
Well, I'm happy that.
How many things you need to open?
This lady is so much in my business. I don't understand. Y'all don't see that?
Because I'm just talking about stuff and it's like, you know.
My mindset is all over the place. I'm a multitasker and I don't need people in my business while I'm doing my thing. So, anywho, like, literally, the truth is, the fact of it is, like, you got to laugh about it, too. The things that you have to do your rebirth, it'd be like, life is so simple, but we make it so hard for ourselves.
Right.
To thanks so much for the like and the love. I really appreciate it. Make sure you say, hey, what's up? Let us know you're here. Like, we love when you guys say hello. Don't play games with us tonight, sir and ma'am.
Go ahead.
Sangria for the night. Make sure you pop up your sangrias.
Anyways, go ahead, girl.
Go ahead, girl. Go. What are we talking about? That's what happens. You drink too much. You don't know what you're talking about. No,
I don't even drink. Like, I don't even enjoy
drinking. I love sweet drinks. So, but the thing about sweet drinks, it definitely makes me sick.
Yeah. I'm not a good sweet drinker type of person. I'm a...
And then when you throw up, you just feel the sweetness and you're like, oh, goodness.
That's
disgusting, but it's the truth.
Right.
Now, all you taste, everything you taste, is water. Just the sweet thing that you just had. It's like, why? Don't drink. It's not good for you.
I don't promote drinking.
No, it's not good.
I'm not like the like I said, the older I get, the more I realize.
The wiser you get. And yeah. Beautiful thing.
Because that's literally spirits. Mm-hmm. Like, you're just being able to, okay, let me just break it down. Mm-hmm. Because I said I wouldn't go down this road, but hey, we're talking about
alcohol. We're rabbits. So tonight we're going down. Go ahead.
Ibrahim says, did you know who saved you? Jesus. Okay. Amen? I don't know. Jesus did save you.
Jesus be the savior.
Right. Glory be the God. Jesus did save you. You almost died.
Girl, if you guys want me to go down a rabbit hole.
No. you know what? I went through some life and death situations so many times as a young person. Mm-hmm. I'm still young. But like, I'm talking like the late teens. Mm-hmm. And I'm so grateful to be alive. Maybe I died those times in, you know, just rebirth.
Girl, I've been death so many times.
Yeah. Some parts of my life, I was literally dead. You know, like, how, like, it's like a block, like, you don't remember. Mm-hmm. Like, literally, you know, like, in WandaVision, it's like, if you don't go, because all of what WandaVision was, sorry, spoiler alert if you guys didn't see it, all of what WandaVision was basically showing you that was her mind. Mm-hmm. This was what the mind, the world she created in her mind.
Right.
So the people who were on the edge of the road as Vision kept walking, they were basically dead. They weren't alive. They weren't doing, like, because they weren't in her proximity of her mind. Mm-hmm. So they were just fillers, background people. So, like, in my life, like, certain parts, certain ages, I'm like, I wasn't even alive for that. It was like driving down the street and, you know, how you blank out and you don't even know how you got where you got to. Mm-hmm. And it's like your mind goes on autopilot and then you go somewhere else. I swear I just autopilot some of my ages. Like, I don't remember nine. I don't remember.
It's true.
Like, I can't pinpoint. I can name events, certain things, but I don't remember the day to day. I don't even sometimes remember, you know, when I first moved here. Like, certain parts of it, or like when I first met people, like, when, how did I meet you?
Sometimes, like, after I meet them, like, I don't even remember them in my lifetime.
Yeah.
And then they come and they tell me who they are, and I'm like,
right,
I forgot that lifetime.
That was interesting. Tone Deaf says, happy Easter, ladies.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter. We're the little bunnies. Yes, guys, make sure you are hitting up TDR Network to listen to podcasts that we are on. So check us out on there. But yeah, your little bunnies are here.
Your little honey bunnies.
You know, bunnies don't even lay eggs. But we were doing, I guess they wanted eggs.
And they want us to have Easter egg hunt like we did today. It was so fun, wasn't it?
Yeah, I like Easter egg hunts. I'm like a big kid. I like to do activities.
I created that event. Yeah. I like to create activities. And it was fun because we did that and it was super fun. We'll put a little clip later on. Not tonight, but not on the show.
Don't mind. I'm just saying
on social media. Go ahead and follow us on our social media if you haven't hit up any of our Instagrams, our YouTube, hi family, I know we're here, so go ahead and follow us on YouTube, Facebook, or Instagram, wherever you came from.
Wherever y'all showed up at.
Anyways.
Yeah.
This is not my real personality. I'm very calm and collective.
Yeah, right. I'm really, like, a great time. No, I think the last time you were on your show for your birthday.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Walling out.
Walling out.
That's me.
Yeah. That's what you like to do.
Mm-hmm. I like to wall out.
It's part of your personality.
Yes, it is. You know what? We literally, this has nothing to do with anything, but
we were anything we say tonight had to do with anything?
I don't really think so. Yeah, it definitely did.
What were we talking about? Let's see if you guys are paying attention. Probably not.
Yeah, because no one's going to respond, huh?
Anyways.
No, I was talking about how we were watching something yesterday and literally on mute. There was nothing to talk about. And we've seen the lady, Tamar.
And we watched Tamar and Vince on mute.
Right, on mute. And it was so weird. We made our own conclusion of what they're talking about.
You should watch things on mute because mm-hmm. you can mm-hmm. see the story. Mm-hmm. I like silent films. Yeah. Like it's kind of like reading a book. Mm-hmm. You have the ability to create the story of right. what's going on. Yeah. And it unfolds itself. I love that. Mm-hmm. I love like mm-hmm. not having all the work done.
No.
You know?
Yeah, I love that too. So yeah. it was pretty cool just watching something on mute. And it was like, and you had put the volume up on something stupid. And I'm like, and then yeah. the thing is back mute. And I'm yeah. like,
yeah.
Interesting.
But we were talking about like background people in our mm-hmm. lives and you know, blocking out those mm-hmm. those events.
Yes.
Just to get back mm-hmm. on topic. Because okay. you know Thank we'd you, be sweetie. Gone.
Thank you.
We'd sweetie. Be like WandaVision. We'd be like here and then we yeah, WandaVision. Mm-hmm.
Got it.
That show I mean that show's been out for a while, so I'm guessing you guys already watched it, but there's so much to decode in mm-hmm. that, and it's like literally telling you like how to manifest. Mm-hmm. She basically manifested it with all of her pain.
Yeah.
But also, you know, with all of the things that she had in her heart, and she got it. And she learned a lot even about herself mm-hmm. in it, which was pretty powerful. Like the villain.
Oh yeah.
She taught her, she even showed her what she did. She mm-hmm. literally, mm-hmm. without her, she wouldn't even have anything.
You are spoiling alert.
I told them, spoiler. Don't listen to that part.
But
you'll hear it. But
and that's why you got to watch things and decode it. Because in yeah. reality,
don't just watch things for entertainment.
No,
because they're telling you.
They're really telling you a whole bunch of.
And we didn't even tell you the deeper thing. We just said yeah. how it relates to you and your life. Mm-hmm. But the deeper parts are even deeper.
So watch it. Make sure you tune in. Yeah, that was a good analogy using WandaVision and having to see that, you know, the people you deal with are background, because at the end of the day, you are the main character in your story.
Right.
So whoever comes in, even if they don't play the part, you got to learn how to take them out. Yeah. They got to die and not be reborn.
Okay. Or replace, recast mm-hmm. them.
Right.
There's like a lot of people, a lot of roles
just like
that just need to be filled.
Right.
And you can recast if that person doesn't fit the role. You can recast or you can just cut the character all together. Mm-hmm. It's up to you.
Yeah. And the same goes with what's that show? Bewitched. Didn't they recast the husband? The husband.
Yeah.
And people didn't. Yeah. It's like, yeah, people can be recasted. Like,
right.
Doesn't I don't matter. Think... They don't even have to look the same as the other person, but kind of because people have like, you know, they have their type.
People don't look the same.
But it's like some kind of similar characteristic.
Girl, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air recasted Aunt Viv from a dark-skinned lady to a light-skinned lady.
Okay.
They don't have to look the same. That's clear as day. And so called her Aunt Viv. Mm-hmm. It's like, did he get a new wife or we gonna act like...
Oh, yeah, that's true.
He's like, we traded Aunt Viv in. Okay. Mm-hmm. And that's what I'm saying. There are people who actually live their lives like that. And some people don't. You know, I seen an interview with Young Ma, and she was saying that the rapper Young Ma, if you guys know who it is, mm-hmm. and she was basically saying that people shouldn't, her day ones, mm-hmm. she doesn't take that code, like, and she has to, like, take care of her day ones. She feels like if she got it, her homies and stuff like that should get it too. Like they shouldn't be looking at her for like handouts. Cause mm-hmm. it's like, that's what's going to make her broke. And she has her family to worry about. Mm-hmm. And I was like, yeah, that's so true.
That's reasonable.
Yeah. That you shouldn't do that. You're not anybody's parent.
No.
And I looked in the comments mm-hmm. and people were like, what? Like, oh, cause your homies don't got money. You can't mess with them. Like,
cause she's not a bro.
She doesn't understand the bro code. She doesn't. I was like,
first of all,
what?
Mm-mm. No.
This is what people, this is how like people end up in jail because of this bro code. This following the whole like code of the streets and code of this, like y'all messing yourselves up with that because
that is not an independent living.
Yeah, no. That is not gonna bring you anywhere other than down. Like I remember when I was in school and I was cool and hung out with friends. Yeah, that whole code and trying to click up and be cool and stuff like that, that doesn't get you far in life. That gets you right now. That's comfort for right now. That's, you know, the confidence in that moment. But in the long run, or even the next day, or even after that moment fades, there's real consequences to your actions and the things that, you know, you do.
And if it doesn't come now, it's going to come later on in life.
Well, I mean, what would you do if you had like a significant amount of money and you had like your bros or whatever or girls? Would you give them?
I didn't have to have a significant amount of money to already start doing that. I already have done that before.
But would you, with a significant amount of money, help your friends?
No, I probably would in the beginning, and then I was because I've I didn't have to have a significant amount of money, and I've helped my bros before, you know?
Yeah.
And I had to learn during that time. So I know when it happens that I would never, I wouldn't even be associated with them. I already had my
debt. That's what I'm saying.
That wouldn't even happen.
I think that's what she's saying. Like, for me, I would like, that would never happen.
No.
Because I've already did it and I've learned my lesson, and I'm not going
to. First of all, I don't even have bros. Bros is like, she's talking
girls,
about,
like your homies, like your friends.
Oh, even her girlfriends too, because I know she chills with a lot of guys.
Well, her friends.
Okay.
Period. Like, are you going to take care of your friends?
No, I'm not taking care of my friends.
Especially if you're care of your family. And I think that's unfair for anybody to ask to, as a friend, to take care of them if, you know,
got other things going on. And first of all,
why is a man asking me to take
care of
him?
Your friend, that person has to come up with something. Like, if they're asking me for something, it has to do with like doing something together. Like, oh, you want to invest in something together? Like, that makes sense that we both did our research and we're going to do something to make more.
Right.
Like, it has to go down to that for me to be involved with my friend. But this bro looks like he wants a handout. So
No. The whole time. Like not even
trying. So I mean, obviously you're gonna help people, but
I've helped people like literally and it was like a handout. And everybody that I helped was like a handout. And every time it's like I got a slap in the face at the end. I like great things happen in my life and I'm grateful and you know, I like that. Crypto Dark Pool. Happy Easter, ladies.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
YouTube family.
Okay.
We're so excited because
if I know who you are,
right?
It sound like I do, but
we don't know who you are, but what's up?
What's up? Welcome. Thank you. Thank you for commenting.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for being here.
Thanks for signing in.
Thank you for
hit the love button. Hit the like button on YouTube.
Hit the luck. Hit the luck button. That's what you said.
The luck button, right? Send me some luck.
I'm already lucky. But like we were saying, Crypto Dark Pool says, "What about Charles Barkley's statements today?"
We don't know. Tell us what he said.
What did he say?
We don't know nothing about Charles Barkley.
Which one is that? The basketball guy? What did he say?
Yeah, what he said.
Let's see.
What Charles Barkley? I was like Charles Barkley, CryptoPonics. I don't know who that is. Oh, okay. That pulled up quick.
What was his tweet?
Was it 4 hours ago?
Let's see. Did you respond? What did he say?
What did he say? Let us know what he said.
What did he say? Let's see who gets it first. I've decided to identify as Chinese. Coke will like me. Delta will agree with my values. And I probably get shoes from Nike and tickets to the MLB games. Ain't America great? Wait, this is somebody else? Wait, I'm looking at the wrong thing.
That's a Caucasian man.
That was
funny. Is that what he said?
That was funny.
Right.
What was the thing? Because we looking at the wrong stuff.
Right. Like, help us.
Right. Tell us what he said. We don't know what that man said.
Was that him? Maybe that was his name. Maybe that's what he said.
No, this is Huckleberry. I mean,
Huckleberry.
Huckabee. Governor Mike Huckabee. That's what that guy said.
A governor saying that?
Mm-hmm. He's saying, like, basically minorities
rule.
Yeah.
Now we rule. No, you don't rule. You're not Asian.
Oh, Asians are ruling right now because they turned into the new black people.
Mm-hmm. And they're going to do it right.
Yeah.
Sorry, black people.
That's true.
They're going to show you how to do it. They're going to show you how to do it.
Thanks. So what are your thoughts on that?
We don't know. Was that what was he that, said? Was it the Asian
was
thing?
Was it Huckabee? What Charles Barkley say? Let's hold on.
Let's do it with them and then play.
Let's see this then. How you do it?
You don't know nothing, huh?
Screen.
Yeah. And then you go to that.
Wait, hold on. Right?
Yep.
This?
Exactly.
Okay.
So we don't know if this is the article you were talking about. I mean, well, obviously you're talking about the tweet.
Are you talking about this thing?
Let us know.
Let's see, guys.
Shared that news, how painful it was.
Yeah, but the one thing I took out of that piece was, man, I think most white people and black people are great people. I really believe that in my heart. But I think our system is set up where our politicians, whether they're Republicans or Democrats, are designed to make us not like each other so they can keep their grasp of money and power. They divide and conquer. I truly believe in my heart most white people and black people are awesome people. But we're so stupid following our politicians, whether they are Republicans or Democrats. And their only job is, hey, let's make these people not like each other. We don't live in their neighborhoods. We all got money. Let's make the whites and blacks not like each other. Let's make rich people and poor people not like each other. Okay. Let's scramble the middle class. I truly believe that in my heart.
Shared that news, how painful it was.
Okay. Sean says, we're so stupid following our politicians. How do you know who he is? I mean... Damn. Hope y'all didn't catch that. Okay, I'm going to put this link in the chat.
Oh my God, it's so funny. I can't be tearing up tonight.
This is where we got this from.
I'm going to look so ugly. Y'all are crazy.
Is this the link? Is it? That guy? Okay. Let me see. I think we got it. That was it, right? That would just happen. I think that was the right one. Thanks, TDR Network, dropping this link. That was the same link. Yeah. Okay. We're so stupid following our politicians. Charles Barkley unleashed 1 minute of truth on America. Right. Facts.
What do you think about that? Guys.
Yes. I've been screaming this.
Yeah, of course.
From the top of my
lungs. I'm so happy that he
for how long?
I'm so glad that he said it on a platform where people. No? It's not it.
Send us what you're talking about.
Then. Right. Send us a link, please.
Please.
Please. Pretty please.
Go ahead.
But even with that, what we just played, I felt like I'm glad that he said that on a platform because everybody watched ESPN. I don't know. Was that on there? Was that ESPN? Or wherever he was.
Yeah, that's it. Sorry. Okay.
Cool. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
No worries. But him saying that and just like letting people know, like the color situation at the end of the day, like it doesn't matter. We're all human beings. They just want us to divide us, like either if we're rich or poor, we're black or white, we're Asian. It doesn't really matter because at the end of the day, you are who you are. And if people want to get along with you, they will get along with you. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't, but we're so busy in the politics and making them decide who we should be and who we should connect with and all this great stuff. But I'm glad he said something about it.
I don't think it's great stuff. I think that's the same
thing. I don't think it's great stuff, but I'm just saying, like, that to them, it's great stuff because they know that it's working. People are agitated and really, like, beating Asian people up all over the place because that's the crime right now. It's just like they're choosing things. One moment it was a Black Lives Matter. Now it's Asian. And next thing you know, it's going to be the Hispanic because I didn't think they got their time yet. No, they already did with Trump.
The immigration is happening.
Right. So everybody's just getting their time. And the Asian is still combined with the Indians. But, like, you know, everything is just like each region is getting their time of hate. What do you think?
I agree with that. But with the politics thing, I think that it's very true. Like, people, I always say this, you're going to agree and disagree with both things both sides represent. So it's comical to see people argue about both of them because both of them make sense. Mm-hmm. And there is a position, I think Jordan Peterson said it. He's like, it's kind of like, you know, the Republicans would be like the CEOs, the one who works the company, the one who, the one who works the company and the one who's there. And the liberals, the Democrats, they're the ones who are like the progressive and making sure that everybody in the company is getting their just due, getting their fair. They're like, mm-hmm. you know, there to fight for your rights, or the progressive one and the innovative one that created the job to begin with. But you need that structure in the background that's going to, you know, make sure the company is running right. That's mm-hmm. just saying it in the company terms, but you need both for the company to succeed. Okay. So at the end of the day, when people use that as a reason to even have a conversation or to like somebody or dislike somebody, it's like people are built, they've been staying in the house mm-hmm. and right now, politics is like an all-time high. Like mm-hmm. I, at a time, would meet people, we would not be talking about politics. That right. would not be something they would talk to me about. Mm-hmm. And now it's like everybody wants to talk about it. And it's just like, this is the trend now. And it's like to fuel more and more hate, mm-hmm. fuel more and more fear, mm-hmm. fuel just all of this.
And judgment.
Low vibrating energy mm-hmm. that you don't even need. Because like I say all the time, like racism and those things, they hardly let up in person. I've never had a person in my face, and I've been around, like, when I was younger, dealt with a lot of elderly Caucasian people, and these were the most racist people, you know, around. And never in my face, even dealing with them, and they're older, doesn't need to care about my feelings, mm-hmm. never experienced that. And yes. that was when I said, it doesn't hold up in person. And I've had people say, oh my God, da-da. Because when it comes down to person-to-person interaction, everybody's the same. We have very few differences. Mm-hmm. We all live life very similarly, especially in America. Mm-hmm. So it's really just a divide and conquer thing
yeah.
and a way to get money. And you just got to know the scheme of things. Like mm-hmm. we always say, like they're always finessing you. Mm-hmm. And anytime somebody wants you to do something, like literally watching the news is like mm-hmm. a clown show. Mm-hmm. Like they're literally arguing different points that it's like, who cares what you think? Right. Like, you know,
right.
it's like, I think this and this and this. And it's like, oh, well, you're making these good points, but is it going to change anything? Mm-hmm. No. Okay, good. Okay, great. It's like Black Lives Matter standing outside and screaming and telling their truth. But it's like, you can say it. Is it going to change anything? Mm-hmm. And it's like, no. It's just another tool being used to divide. Because they're going
to
continue
to add more fuel to the fire anyways.
So. Right. Hmm. Similar stuff Richard Pryor talked about. Right. And that right there is prime example that this stuff is never going to end. It's mm-hmm. going to be, you know, in every generation. And it's just as relevant. And it's so crazy. Like when you read books from like, the 50s or even 30s, 20s, like really old books, it's literally the same stuff.
It's like they were talking about right
this
now.
This time.
You're like, this is still happening, I guess.
Like, all you had to do was throw social media in there, and we're talking about the same exact thing.
Right. It's crazy.
It's never going to change. And I think
it's
that
just going to look a little different, but yeah, it's not going to change.
That's why, similar to Jordan Peterson, I believe in that individual kind of way of doing things. Like, if you individually work on yourself and you make yourself better, and then you help the person that closest to you, and they make themselves better, and then they help, like, you kind of have to do like a referral basis in a way for people to really better themselves, because the masses aren't the way censorship is working, the way everything is,
like, you,
the masses aren't going to get any information that is going to tell them this is how we unite and this is how we get better. It's going to be continued problems.
And then they're going to also, like, censor the crap out of everything that you said. Because they have this new thing that's going on with the fact checkers.
Crypto Dark Pool says, right, the new WWE, basically. We've been in WWE. This is SmackDown.
Yeah.
This is Royal Rumble. This is, what is WrestleMania? This is, who are you? I'm Lita. Who are you going to be?
I don't know.
I'm going to be Lita and the Hardy Boys.
Okay. I'm going to be Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Okay.
There you go. Okay. We seen him recently. We're like, dang, you still look good. And then I said, this is going to be wrong. And you couldn't say I'm wrong. And then I said to myself, the reason why he didn't, you know, he's not like The Rock, because they came out at the same time.
Right.
Because he wasn't. No. Beep, beep.
Yeah,
he wasn't,
so,
no.
We, yeah.
we know. I'm saying it louder for the people in the back.
The people in the back need to hear.
But anyways, yeah, so, yeah, it is turning into a basically WWE.
Ibrahim says, this happens in my country as well. Right. It happens in every country.
Right.
This is the way of the world. This is how they rule. This is how you rule people. You have to divide them. That's the only way that you can rule a person or a people, a group of people. You have to make them think a certain way, and you have to make them think these people who think differently from you are the problem. This is the same, you know, they've been using this tactic, you know, since the ancient time.
Yeah.
I mean, they've been going into the missionary. I mean, this is everybody's tactics from religion to everything. They go into something and with a group of people and say, this is how you're supposed to think. I bring you the knowledge. This is truth. This is this.
Just
think
like this.
Thing. Exactly. Think like this. This is how you're supposed to think. And then those people over here who don't think like you, they have their own way of thinking.
Right.
They're the bad ones.
They're the wrong ones.
Right.
Don't follow their leads. Kill them.
Right.
That's what they're going to start doing next.
That's hang them. That's actually what happened in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
That was what God told. Well, they said they.
Don't be seeing people's stories now.
It's in the Bible. It says those people over there, they praise different gods. They praise the false god. Go into there. And, you know, kill them, basically. You need to go over there. You need to shut them down because they don't follow the true God. That's everybody.
Oh, that's why they're killing us now.
In the art,
makes sense.
The art of war, it's like you got to go in there and divide the people. Mm-hmm. And as Americans, like, I was saying this the other day, like, I love any place in the world. I love traveling. I love foreign places. I love all of that. But there's something to be very proud and happy and grateful about to be born in America. And this is something that I think, because my family were first generation Americans, you know, came from a different country, and knowing the life that my parents had and knowing the life that we have here, it's a completely different way of living. And it's like, dang, I'm so happy if I was born anywhere in the world that I was born here, because I have so many opportunities here. Mm-hmm. Like, literally, you can go be born in Venezuela and you could never be rich. Mm-hmm. You can go and, like, you don't have as much opportunities. And that's why a lot of people here, this is why the immigration thing is, like, this is the land of possibilities. And so I think everybody in America, we all share that. And by that being a reality for us, I think that is important that we stick together. It's like, hey, because Americans like are like the last ones to make money in America. Because people who come into America, they come here with a dream. They come in here with a goal a purpose to do something, to become something, because in their country, it's you're capped. They literally cap you over there. You're capped.
And you can, in some countries over there, like you can't even but some countries like their citizens can't have their own business.
Right.
Like, you can't do that. So that's why they do come to America.
Or there's not even a way for them to get enough money to start a business. Or, it's just owned up, or it's, you know, corrupt. There's so many other things. So when people come into America, they come in here with a dream.
Right.
And then, like, the problem is, like, with Americans, you spoiled. It's like, I got you. Crypto Dark Pool says, Denzel Washington, if you don't read the newspaper, you're uninformed. If you read it, you're missing. I think I get what you mean. And that's very, very true. That's very true. You have to know what's going on, but you don't need to be corrupt by it.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
You can be very informed and not be corrupted by it. And I don't think anybody can look at, like I was saying, with the whole thing about the American people and realizing that, you know, we're all here just trying to make it in life and trying to, you know, do what's best for us. Mm-hmm. There's so much against you. And it's not just it's against Black people. The way that, like I said, with the food issue, the way they put hormones, everybody's being attacked.
And that's the crazy thing.
Not white, Black, rich thing. Like, everybody could get sick. Anybody could
die. And they want the American people or the universal people, the humans, they want us to think it's a racist thing. They want us to think it's how much you're richer than anybody, or you're poor, or any of those things. Economy thing.
It's way deeper than
nothing about that. It's literally, it's all a game. Everything is a game here. And that's why you have to, as an individual, seek your own truth, seek your own knowledge, because not everything that's given to you is the truth.
Right.
And don't be fearful about that. I remember when I was kind of scared to go down that rabbit hole and figure out who I was and let go of a lot of things. And even being religious, I was a religious person on my own. I'm not going to go down this rabbit hole with anybody, but I'm just saying, like, I was not super religious, but I was religious because of my family, but that wasn't who I was individually. But kind of it was, because as I got older, I actually decided to go to church. I decided to, like, you know, seek my own truth on my own. And it wasn't my parents or anything. And it was just me. And then I went down another rabbit hole, and it was like, oh, okay.
You kept on going and uncovering.
Right.
And that's what life is about. Right. I think you never, ever supposed to stay at the same level. If you believe and think the same way you did 10 years ago, you're doing something wrong. You're doing something wrong. Something is wrong. If you've been thinking the same way for even 1 year, like, I get so many times in my life where I contradict myself and I change the way that I think, that I'm never, like, constantly, like, in the same thought, like, where I'm like, oh, I still think that's true. Sometimes, like, in certain things, but certain things change about that.
Right.
Certain things,
and even the things that you eat, even that changed. Like, you know, like, I used to be a basic type of eater. Like, oh no, I don't like any extra nothing. Don't put any other extra vegetables on there. No, I don't like things like that. I'm scared. No, no. Right. And now, as I'm older, it's like, oh, vegetables, oh, this, okay, onions, all right, add them up, okay, bell peppers, all right, I'll do that, okay, I'm getting a little out there, okay, so, yeah, you have to be different, like, you have to, like, kind of figure out what you like. I think that is, like, I was scared to add extra stuff to my thing, and it's just like, no, like, add them, like, try new things.
Add them.
Adam.
Jay says true.
Okay.
Hey, Jay.
Hi, Jay.
Welcome on in. I'm sure you already hit that like, but just in case you didn't.
Right.
Hit it right now.
Hit it again.
But yeah, I think that all of that, uh-huh. all of that is true. And I think that, like I was saying, even about the analogy, like anytime I come in, and this is weird, but anytime I'm a very like empathic person.
Okay.
So anytime I come into the country and, you know, you're coming through customs and American customs, uh-huh. I have like a sense of pride to be back at home mm-hmm. in America. I don't know. Cause they tell you that like, oh, welcome home. Like, well, when like, you come in and
home.
I'm like, I'm back home in America.
Welcome, like, welcome back. Opening your doors and everything. Did you have a lovely trip?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Misinformed. Right. If you read it, you're misinformed. Okay, right. Got it. Exactly. You are misinformed mm-hmm. if you read it and you live by it. And there's so many people.
That's the same thing like watching that, like, a
did
movie.
You see this?
Did you hear about this? Or did you hear about... And I'm like... That's what you got out of that?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Okay. Yeah. That's. I didn't even see that part.
Like, I was like, I went to girl.
And but the thing of it is like you just gotta know that not everything needs your reaction. Not everything needs your energy. Not everything needs your opinion.
And we said that last week about the emotions. Like you need to not have your emotions when you're handling things.
Right.
And
right.
when you're heading things.
Right.
Just really like, you can't get butt hurt every time.
Right.
And it sucks when you do, because I've been that person, because I'm very an emotional being. I'm like, everything I take to heart, like, oh, you're hurting my feelings. But I have to learn that, like, I have to leave my emotions at the door. If it comes down to business, if it comes down to anything, like, I can't be emotional about it. I gotta actually, like, hear the information and see... You know what I learned? If you are that type of person that is an emotional being, that everything you take emotional, you take seriously, take breathe.
Right.
Yoga is the best thing to do, because mm-hmm. that breathing technique that you do, it literally can get the results in. I took a breath when I was super emotional, angry, upset, about to actually put my hands on somebody, and then I said,
"Damn, you get that mad?"
I got that mad.
Yeah.
I don't physically put my hands on people, but like, you ever seen
you get
a movie?
Energy,
you like, ever seen that movie when it's like,
it cuts,
you know,
the clip,
right?
And they're like,
it's like, and they're
react.
Really doing that to you? That's me. So yeah. I won't do it to you like physically, but I will do it to you like
mentally.
Yeah. Beat the crap out of you.
And sometimes that's all you gotta do sometimes.
Hey, I'm honest. I gotta
But that's like facts. Like sometimes you just come into a situation and it's just like, I gotta take myself out of this situation, or I got to not react in any type of
or
way.
Not be around things that actually get me on that energy, you know?
Period.
It's like, step away.
Yeah.
Oh, bad news. These news things that's coming up.
But the news is there for entertainment. This is what I've been screaming to people. Every day, you ever watch a TV show, like a crime show, not even a crime show, just like a TV show about anything.
Mm-hmm.
There's always drama, right? There's always something next. Like they get through one problem, there's another one right behind it. There's another one always. This is the news.
This thing is
the news will
problem.
Always tell you the next problem.
Like
the
Vampire Diaries.
Yeah. The next thing to be mad about. Mm-hmm. There's no chill.
Right.
It's always going to just keep
I'm
going.
I'm like, how do they still want to live?
Yo, they don't want you to live. They want you to vibrate on this low energy that's like, the world is going crazy. We're all going to die.
Right.
And it's miserable. So then everybody can manifest that. And it's just literally like, keep manifesting this level, this low level energy, and everybody
that
the
we
world
have a problem with
every
crashing.
Race. When in reality, you just don't. Mm-hmm. And I don't know everybody's experience, but I know my experience. And that's what I think everybody should go by, their own experience, not everybody's collective experience, because it's not the same. I don't even experience that.
Yeah.
Individually, like I said, I've seen people like all ranges of people, nothing. And if they did, it was not so clear that it would be offensive to me because nobody's going to step to you and say nothing. No. Really, people barely look you in your eyes. Right. No, I don't buy that. Like people are looking at Facebook, looking at the internet and saying, look, this is what's happening. If it's not happening in my face, if I'm not seeing it, it's not happening. Like, it's just not happening in my world. And that keeps you sane. No.
Mm-hmm.
Jay says, I dated an Aka woman and she was depressing. Right. Oh my God, Jay. I know you definitely, you go on a lot of dates. So you got to tell us about that. I know she was depressing. Like, no, lady, we don't want to hear about what happened in Benghazi. Like, we trying to talk about, you know, regular things. What movie you watch? What TV show you watching right now? Shireen says, hi, my sisters. Happy Easter. You ladies look good.
Aww,
hi, sister. Hi. Please. Happy Thanksgiving.
I mean, we told you from the beginning, we celebrate Thanksgiving. So every holiday is Thanksgiving.
Happy Easter.
I mean, Easter.
Happy Easter, Shireen.
Happy
Love
Easter,
you.
Andy.
Roland. Thank you for watching.
Thank you, family.
Thank you, family. Yes. Yeah, I bet you, like, anchor women or any woman that does a masculine job.
Mm-mm.
Like, this one lady, she was my mentor, and she was a very successful designer, and she was a single woman, and so she would date, and she would tell me about, like, what her conversations were.
What was her kind of conversations?
Very like the stock market, business, stuff like that. And I'm just like, I don't know. Like, for me, it's like, that's cool with friends. But if I'm dating somebody, like, I don't want to talk about that. Like, let's talk about things that,
what
like,
if he,
your real personality.
Did she feel like he enjoyed that? Like, did she talk to him again? Like,
well, that's the thing with women who are like alpha or like bossed up and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. They don't really care what other people.
Oh yeah, the non-agreeables.
Yeah, they're the non-agreeables. Mm-hmm. The non-agreeables don't think about others and how they're receiving the conversation. They're just giving the conversation, and then they're critiquing your conversation,
right,
to see if it's aligned. But they're not necessarily
caring about what you think
about what they're saying, because they believe what they're saying is 100 and valid, which it is, but is it
if I was
right?
A guy, I would have been like, I just talked about that 2 minutes ago with my buddy.
Right. I don't want to talk about that. I don't know.
Do
I don't think,
else, ma'am.
I don't, especially you, Jay, let us know what kind of conversations do men like on going on dates. Yeah, you too, Crypto. You tell us.
Yeah, Crypto and TDR
Jay,
Network.
All the guys that's in here, let us know what kind of conversations you guys like having on dates with women.
So women can stop talking.
Because I'd rather have a conversation about like real things, personality wise, things that you like to do, traveling, and like what we're doing.
Yeah.
Like, especially, that's why it's good, I think, to do an activity for a date.
Yeah.
So then the conversation becomes what you did.
Yeah. Cause
and you build
have
a
to
memory
do with what you're talking. Like, yeah, it's just a new thing.
Jay says, I talk about playing golf. Right. So you're talking about a hobby that you only care about, which is what men do.
Oh.
And women just sit there and just like, okay, that's great.
Okay,
you're
going
to teach me? That's what they want to hear. They don't want to hear.
Oh, that's why they bring it up that they play golf. So women can say, can you take me?
Can you teach me?
Oh, can you teach
or
me?
Or no, because, you know, guys, well, usually I would think the usual thing is like, oh, I don't play golf. Like, the girl would be like, oh, I don't play golf, but I, you know, would love to try sometime. Mm-hmm. I've been thinking about taking lessons. Like, I'll teach you. That's usually what the guy would say.
Mm-hmm.
And then that would be like, oh, really? That would be great. Yeah, we can go next time when we go out. Mm-hmm. And that's his way in for this next day.
Okay.
I know how I go.
Wow.
Jason, blah, blah, blah. Is that how it goes? Is that how the conversation goes?
He was
goes?
Like, exactly correct, ma'am.
He was like, that's exactly how I got golf dates every time. Yeah, because that's the only way. Because if you come out the bat like, oh, well, sometimes a guy could be like, do you play golf? And it's like, yes or no. Mm-hmm. But he's always going to suggest to teach. It's like, do you play tennis? Yes or no? Okay, I can teach you.
So,
da-da-da-da. And that's
with
the
golf,
activity.
I feel like they got the opportunity to touch you.
They got the opportunity to touch you for everything. What are you talking about?
That's like, true. There's always an opportunity for a man to touch you.
No, I'm
just, stay woke, ladies.
Right. These guys, all they want to do is touch you.
You give them like, 5 feet. Hey, right. COVID is your best friend now. COVID, that's the thing.
Teach me without touching me. You stand there and show me like this. He's going to be like, no.
If the online teacher can teach me without touching me or being next to me, you can definitely teach me from
over there. He's like, girl, this is my date.
Girl, stop playing.
Yeah, exactly. Show me how. This is how you do it.
How we get into that conversation?
I'm just saying. I know y'all men. Y'all love that physical touch.
J-Dub says, Catherine, let's go play golf.
Nice try, buddy.
He's trying to go play golf with you.
You want
to
get your lesson?
Yeah. He's like, actually, that's, you want to go?
You want to?
She's allergic to golf.
I'm allergic to golf. I don't know how to play and I'm scared.
No, just she has a phobia with golf balls.
Isabel's silly tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Hit the love button, hit the like button, let everybody know you're here. It's been an hour of our time, yeah. And we're not going to go anywhere until you tell us to get out of here. Laugh out loud. You a funny little man.
Hey, what? He's like, what?
Girl, I'm a big man. What you talking about?
Okay.
See ya.
We don't know what kind of man you are.
Right. We don't know you. Show up.
We know Jay.
We know Shay. Shay.
We know Jay. We know Jay.
She's a, Jay for sure.
She said your name in French.
You Jay. That's Shay. Shay Jay.
Merci Jay.
Merci. Tutu.
Anyways, like I said,
I don't even know.
In the first conversation that we were talking about,
yeah,
with that guy's comments.
What guy's comments?
Charles Barkley's comments.
Yeah. Thank you, Charles.
He's speaking facts. He's speaking truth.
And he's being so calm.
A lot of people said it.
Everybody's like, yeah.
Yeah. And they want, and this is both sides. Mm-hmm. I'm not even talking about like even the news. They have agents. This is the thing. People gotta know. Like these people who want you to get mad with other people to keep on dividing, mm-hmm. dividing, and not and realizing conflict. That you guys are just vulnerable. People, one people, mm-hmm. you're a race,
a
of
human
beings,
race.
Then you realize why am I? Why do
Let
I
me
even
say
care?
Something? I'm gonna use humans as crayons. Okay, so you have the crayon box. Do you just take one crayon and I'm only gonna color everything in this one color, mm-hmm. this one particular? No, you're not. You're going to actually use every single color in the crayon box, unless you don't want to use like. I don't know, the darkest gray or I don't freaking know, but you are going to use every color because you like to see what it's going to turn out to be. So why are we as human race taking offense of people because of the color and complexion of their skin?
Right.
It's dumb. I'm going to judge you for who you are. I'm not going to be like, oh, you're a black person, so I'm not going to hear what you got to say. No, you're an Asian person. I'm going to hear what you got to say. You're a Hispanic person. I don't want to hear what you got to say. No, I'm going to hear what you got to say, and I'm going to judge you from what you're saying. Okay? Right. You sound dumb. You sound dumb.
You sound smart. You sound smart.
You sound like I want to hang out with you. I'm going to hang out with you. You sound like you...
Yeah.
A dusty, a tacky, this. That's what I call you guys. I call you name different things. I don't mm-hmm. even call you colors. I call you other things. I don't have to. Because I love the human race. And I'm sure you all do too. Hit the love button if you agree. What do you think as well?
Huh?
What do you think?
What?
What you just said?
Wow. Oh, no.
You know what?
Look,
I'm gone.
Take off your stuff. I'm getting text messages and this too. Sorry. But you were saying you're very
tell them to
true.
Sign in.
Yeah.
Sign in.
Come put
sign
your
in and comment
in
down here.
Because I'm too, I can't multitask because she's trying to talk. I'm trying to read this and the comment.
You're messing up the show. Just hit the comment button.
Just or call in.
Call in.
Anybody want to call in?
Call in before we hang up.
Yeah. Let me give y'all something. If y'all want to call in, call in. And if not, we out in 5 minutes. How yeah. about that?
Colin.
Anyways. Thank you. Yes.
Colin.
Colin.
Shoot. We ain't going to be playing this game with y'all tonight.
Right.
Beating people through the screen.
Thank you, TDR.
Thank you, TDR Network,
yes.
for actually being on tonight.
Yo.
Doing your thing.
Doing it tonight.
The link is in the bio.
Okay.
No, I mean the comments. So hit it up.
You're
let
right.
us know what you
gotta say
that. But you're saying like super facts.
Of course.
But I think like even like people, like I always like even with the Black Power movements and stuff like that, you
power
know,
to the people.
I support that as well.
I think Crypto had Crypto something. Uh-huh. He had power to the people in his
right. Life. And I think that of course you support that. Of course you want that. Of course that's a thing. But even the extreme of that isn't good. Like when they say, you know, I remember when I was shopping religions and I stumbled upon Hebrew Israelites.
Oh my God. And I was right there.
I was like, what they were saying, because I'm going to give everybody a shot to tell me what they got, you know? Mm-hmm. And they was spilling. And I'm like, okay, yeah. Okay, what that verse say? Mm-hmm. Oh, shoot. That's it now. You know, I wasn't reading that. You know, they pull out their Bible and tell
they
you.
They think they're so smart.
Yeah, and they say the, some stuff. Yeah, they're smart. You, that'll get you.
Yeah.
And then they hit the Caucasian race. Oh. And they, like, hate. It was,
they
like.
They hate them. They're so racist towards them.
Oh, my God. It was crazy.
I was like, you know what? I'm not that racist.
I seen so a I'm video try to where this person. Man made a Caucasian woman kiss his feet.
Mm-mm. Because he was spitting the truth into her. He and brainwashed
her. He brainwashed her right there. And she's surrounded by these people. And was she not going to do it? But and get slapped?
Girl, play
you
that
don't
video.
Know what's going on. I can't even play it because we too late. I told y'all 5 minutes in. Y'all want to call in or we out. Anyways.
They want to see it.
I was nah. I can't get with that much hate. Like, you got to really hate these people to like.
They hate them.
It's like. Too much. It's like, I don't even care that much about them. I'm just trying to save myself.
Like, I care about everybody. And I think, I love Caucasian people, too. I love Black people. I love all people.
Because it would be unfair, especially the way I was brought up, and I've had all races of people help me, down to Asian, white, Black.
Like, really help.
Like, even literally.
My family.
Like, my tutors were Asian. My babysitter was white. Mm-hmm. Caucasian. I've had African American, you know, mentors. I've had like just everybody played a part in my life.
Right.
As an American, you will receive that. You will get that. Mm-hmm. So how could you, as a person, be like, nah, they're low, they're this, they're that, and it's like I can't get with this.
I feel like the slavery thing had just definitely brainwashed people to think like so low of themselves.
Right.
And I think I'm not gonna lie. I know it was a hard time, but we didn't actually experience it. So our ancestors or whoever dealt with that, they dealt with that for us not to deal with it.
Y'all don't even know what happened. You back don't know. Then. Y'all don't
There's
even know.
Probably so first many of all, American first people of all, living
first
good.
Of all, they didn't even tell the truth of what even happened and how the slaves got here. Like a lot of American Black people,
they
like,
were already here.
You guys were already here,
right?
Like the same way like the Black people in Haiti, they were already here. Mm-hmm. They already, y'all was already occupied here. Mm-hmm. Like if you think with common sense, that whole all these people were That's shipped over y'all. On a ship, like nah, most of those people would have died, and people were occupying this land already. So why would you go? You could just take these people and make them your slaves. And you're going to realize that even Black people, the Indians who were here already, the Black ones, they had slaves.
Yeah.
Like, slave things was already a thing. Going on. And that's still going on in the Middle East. Like, people really now still have slaves. Mm-hmm. They have little slaves. They have little, they'll call them their pet. I don't know. But they be slaves. Well, you'll see a rich family in the Middle East and they'll have like the slave like sitting in the corner not eating, like wait, like literally they have slaves. Mm-hmm. So this is something that has always happened all over the world. Mm-hmm. And with the Black people, and it's like if they just tell you you was only a slave and don't tell you that you were already here, that you basically just got played, you got finessed, and they, you know, you got like finessed by the Indian people who teamed up with the white people, got their guns, shot you down, turned you the ones that they could into slaves, and just made a whole people of slaves. Mm-hmm. And then they turned on the Indian people, and now they in the same
and
situation.
That's the thing.
That's
the
fact.
This is the manipulation that they play with y'all with the color thing. They make y'all think that everybody's cool. And then at the end of the day, they they finagle you.
Yeah, you gotta know the game, and that's what you said earlier. Mm-hmm. It's like it's a game. So mm-hmm. once you figure out the game, you're like, oh, this is what happened, because they're not gonna tell you the truth of who you really were. There's ancient artifacts, Egyptian artifacts in the Grand Canyon. They're finding things mm-hmm. in Ohio, like little Egyptian, like Black people were already here. Mm-hmm. So they can't tell that, but it's better to tell you you were brought over here. Plus, so then that way they could tell you, hey, go where you came or whatever they say. But it's like, in reality, I was already here. The same thing like the people in Haiti, there's mm-hmm. like the Africans, they were already there. And the Taínos, they were there, but other Indian people. Mm-hmm. And they're basically extinct in Haiti. But it's all of these people who are already here. Mm-hmm. It's like these group of people that came in, the pilgrims, they were the last group to come in. Right. And they came in with all their diseases and all their, you know, mm-hmm. all their things mm-hmm. to, you know, enslave that person.
Right.
The peoples that was here, because mm-hmm. that's what they do. They come in, they bring their religion, they tell you this, they tell you that, they tell you you don't know nothing. Mm-hmm. And then I'll teach you.
Right.
And then by me teaching you, you're going to have to do this. Mm-hmm. And now I own, this is the game. Mm-hmm. And you can't get mad at the game. I mean, you could get mad at the game, just don't get mad at the player, because this game has been played on other people.
That's why people
was the Africans doing it to another group of people.
Right.
It was maybe the Indians doing it to another group. The Persians were doing it to another. It's everybody played the game. And that's the point, that once people realize what really the game is, then you realize, why am I even mad about to my neighbors? Why am I mad to the people who, you know, we need to come together and overcome this smaller group of people? Mm-hmm. No, we're going to keep fighting each other, because it's easier to do that than deal with my truth. It's easier to fight you than fight them, because fighting them would mean that I have to take responsibility of my own life, and I don't want to do that. And that's the reality. So, guys, since nobody called in, I guess you guys didn't want to hear my rant. Mm-hmm. Crypto did write. He said, get deal, don't feed into the BS. Right. Mm-hmm. Never, ever feed into the BS, because that right there is how you get finessed. That is the game for finessing. I've been finessing for a long time, and I'm just trying to let you guys
learn
know
how the game is played, so you could finesse the game. It's okay to finesse the game, because they allow you to do it.
Yeah, they reward the people who finesse the game. Don't you see businesses? They get tax breaks. They literally pay no taxes and brag about it, because they said, you finesse the game. Great job, buddy.
Then
the people who don't finesse the game, they're like, yeah, you keep paying.
Mm-hmm.
You get treated like crap.
And you know, you know what we want you to play? The millionaires and the minimum wage people. Is that for another time?
Yeah, that is too long. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, that was a good one too.
Yeah.
It just showed their mindset, and it was like,
yeah, people. The mindsets are completely different once mm-hmm. you realize that, because like I just said, mm-hmm. it's like they reward the people who know how to play the game, and the mm-hmm. people who don't know how to play the game and don't realize what's going on around them. And I'm not telling you be evil, play their game. I'm telling you get out of their game, see how the game is, and make your own way. You don't have to be the game is not evil. The players mm-hmm. are evil.
Right.
The players choose. No, this is just the
creator of the game. Is
right.
Evil.
Is it?
Or
you don't even know what is evil. What is evil. Good or bad?
They done defined everything for you. You don't even know what
is. But that's the thing. It's like, I feel like people should have personal morals, personal principles. Right. Everybody doesn't follow the same law. Everybody doesn't. All we got is the universal law, which is the nature that governs us. Because we know if the sun don't come up tomorrow, we ain't going to have no good. Like, we going to be worried. If the moon don't show up, if the sun don't show up. Y'all think y'all gonna be here very long?
No.
Y'all know for dang sure. So we're not in control. The nature's in control. Mm-hmm. So all we can do is follow nature's law. And by nature's law, then you got the freedom to do whatever you want within these limitations. Mm-hmm. And then that's all you need.
Mm-hmm.
That's all you need. You don't need their information, their game. Well, you take their information and you make it work for you.
And don't take offense. I mean, like, don't take it emotional. Don't live by what they say.
Right.
You literally take it with a grain of salt.
Right. Everything.
Mm-hmm.
Even what we just said.
Right.
I want people to go do their own research. Have your own idea. Have your own mind about it. Mm-hmm. Stop just like, I agree. So everything they say, I agree with. And then people get disappointed.
Right.
Like I was told me. This is kind of off topic, but like I've seen like, you know how Lizzo is like fat positive or whatever. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they have that whole like body positive kind of thing where they say fat people are healthy and stuff like that. And she's like their frontman for that.
Oh.
And, she had posted that she was doing a detox, and
why she need to do
her because, you know, of course everybody needs to detox.
I mean, yeah, but
that's not even like a fat or small thing. Okay. It comes down to like you need to detox, and her fans like turned on her and was like, I'm so disappointed, I can't believe you're conforming to this, and I really looked up to you. And I'm like, what is wrong with people? Why are you disappointed about people living their own life and doing what they want to do
and be healthy?
Because they don't
lose weight from her detox. I thought you were going to stay fat forever.
Why aren't you fat? Why aren't you doing what you said? It's like, I don't owe you anything.
Just like she's gonna get skinny.
And people are so hell bent on this collective, and we have to collectively think like this. And it's like, no, we don't. We have to accept our differences. And mm-hmm. this is the part of, like, you know, the way things used to be when it's like, oh, like bullies and stuff like that. It's like, accept the bad hands you get, right? Mm-hmm. In like a card game. Like if you got a bad hand, accept that, mm-hmm. right? And play that hand the best way you can, because your finesse, your personality just might make you win. Mm-hmm. No matter how bad your game is, you just might win. Like, no matter how inexperienced you are, like this girl, we would play a board game together. She would literally not know how to play, mm-hmm. and she's still gonna win. And I'm like, how do you win? And
it's like, just me. I'm just me.
And that's all you need to know.
I won. So, I won the
Easter egg hunt.
Yeah. I won everything. Yeah. I'm just a winner, guys.
And okay. I'm a winner too. But yeah, with her,
I'm a winner.
I win in other things where it's more physical.
Okay.
Meaning like driving and when we do races.
Oh yeah. Like if we're driving, this girl, she's a cheater.
I always race you.
And she's a finesse cheater. Yeah. I was like, first of all, she drove through homelessness to win. And I was like, that's messed up.
Girl, I would
never go that way. You're like, what? I gotta do what I gotta do.
Right. Girl. I need to win. I'm a winner. Anyways, right. Guys, but this was fun. Thank you, YouTube family, for being here.
Thank you.
And supporting the channel, dropping your comments, dropping your likes. Appreciate you. Make sure that you guys are following all of the social medias, listening to us on all the streaming platforms.
Right. Listen up. And then also remember to hit up our Cash App.
Oh, if you guys want to support, why not?
Support the kids and hit the Cash App. Say Happy Easter on that Cash App. And
right.
Hey, get yourself something nice for the show so we can, you know, admire it. Because you see the background, we want to add more stuff to it. So
we need new things. We need new flowers.
We need a new setup for the holidays.
For the rebirth.
For the rebirth. So next Sunday we can
look like
a different scene. All right. So hit it up if you can. And then also always remember, it was a good evening. It was a good talk.
Yes.
You went through the rebirth.
We don't even know if that was on tech.
Life,
and rebirth, death. Phoenix rising, all of that. Hopefully you guys got the point.
Yes.
And hopefully you just have a good night. But always remember,
nothing's wrong. See you next time.
Bye, guys. Oh, that's hot.